Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss some important questions from the topic mutual funds. So this is an important topic for your SEBI grade examination. So guys, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. Now let's see the first question. Mutual funds in India are governed by SEBI Mutual Fund Regulations 1996. In which form is a mutual fund set up? In India, SEBI has introduced Mutual Fund Regulations 1996. So these regulations contain provisions regarding mutual funds. So as per these regulations, a mutual fund is set up in the form of a trust, right? And there are majorly four important parties in a mutual fund. So one is a sponsor, then it is trustee, then there is a AMC, asset management company, and then there is a custodian. So these four important parties are there. So in mutual fund, it is formed in the form of a trust. So sponsor is like a promoter who sets up the mutual fund. Trustee, they manage the property of the mutual fund. Asset management company, they manage all the investments. And custodian, they are responsible for safekeeping of securities, right? So the correct option here is option C, trust. Now moving on to the next question, question 2. Consider the below statements regarding open-ended mutual funds. Basically, there are two types of mutual fund schemes, open-ended and closed-ended. So this classification is on the basis of maturity. So let me draw a table of distinction between the two schemes so that it becomes clear to you. So in open-ended mutual fund schemes, there is no fixed subscription period. So an investor can enter any time in an open-ended scheme, and he can also exit from the scheme anytime. But in a closed-ended scheme, there is a fixed subscription period within which investor has to enter into the scheme, right? And also he cannot exit anytime because there is a fixed maturity also. So this was regarding subscription period. Now if I talk about the maturity or the redemption period, so in open-ended schemes, there is no fixed redemption period, but in closed-ended schemes, there is fixed redemption period. So closed-ended schemes, they are for a particular time period. So they have a fixed maturity or fixed redemption, right? Also in open-ended schemes, the investor can directly sell the units to the mutual fund house, and he can directly buy the unit from the mutual fund house. So the units of an open-ended scheme, they are not listed on a stock exchange, but units of closed-ended scheme, they are listed on a stock exchange. And if I talk about the corpus, so the corpus of open-ended scheme, it is variable. So variable corpus. So basically any investor can enter any time in the scheme and also exit from the scheme. So the size of the corpus will keep on changing, obviously, but in a closed-ended scheme, the corpus is fixed. So there is fixed corpus size because an investor cannot enter any time. There is a fixed subscription period, right? So these are basically some of the differences. Now let us see the statement. Statement 1, the period of maturity of the scheme is fixed. So the period of maturity of open-ended scheme, it is not fixed. So statement 1 is incorrect. Now statement 2, the size of the fund does not remain constant. So statement 2 is correct because the size of the fund in an open-ended scheme, it is not constant, it keeps on changing. So statement 2 is right. And statement 3, the units of open-ended scheme are not listed on a stock exchange. So this statement is also right. So the question is asking which of the above statement are incorrect. So you can see only statement 1 is incorrect. So the correct option is C, only statement 1. Now moving on to the third question. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that we have posted this quiz on our website. So we have also posted quizzes on other topics for our SEBI grade examination, and also quizzes for other exams like RBI, NET JRF, they are also being posted. So you can attempt those quizzes and get to know your preparation level. So guys, do visit our website. So the link for the website is provided in the description section below. Now question 3, consider the description about a type of mutual fund scheme. So you are given a description of a mutual fund scheme. You have to identify which scheme is being talked about. So let me read the statements. So the aim of this fund is to provide regular and steady income to the investor. The fund invests primarily in fixed income securities like bonds, debentures, government securities, money market securities, etc. Opportunities for capital appreciation are limited in these schemes, and NAV of these funds is affected by interest rate. So the question is asking, which fund are we talking about? So basically, there are various types of schemes, like growth scheme, then there is income scheme, and there are hybrid schemes, right? And there are many other schemes like money market funds, then there are sector specific funds, there is index fund, there are ETFs, then there is ELSS. So there are a lot of different varieties of mutual fund schemes. You have also gilt funds, right? So there are a lot of other examples also. So in this question, they are talking about income scheme, because in an income scheme, the objective of this scheme is to provide steady income to the investor. So this scheme is more appropriate for people who are retired, who want a steady flow of income, and those who are conservative, right? So this scheme majorly invests in fixed income securities like bonds, corporate bonds, government bonds, debentures, money market securities, right? So these type of instruments. So the correct answer here is income fund. So correct option is option B. And also income fund, they are affected by interest rate because they invest in debt securities, and we know debt securities are directly affected by the interest rates. So here the correct option is option B, income fund. Now question 4, Dash is an open-ended scheme with a lock-in period of 3 years. It is an equity fund. It offers tax benefits to the investors under section 80C of the Income Tax Act 1961. So you have to identify which scheme is being talked about. So you have some clues here. So first clue, it is an open-ended scheme. Then it has a lock-in of 3 years. Also, it is a type of equity fund. It offers tax benefits. So these are some of the clues. So these four things are present in only one scheme, and that is ELSS, Equity Linked Savings Scheme. So this is a type of equity fund, and it has to invest minimum 65% in equities, right? So here the correct option is ELSS, option D. Now moving on to the next question, question 5. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have also discussed this topic on our Telegram group. So we regularly conduct quizzes and post questions on that group. Also, a lot of relevant information regarding examination is being shared. So do join our Telegram group and get the benefits. Now question 5, which of the following statement is not correct about REITs? So what are REITs? So REITs are basically Real Estate Investment Trust. Real Estate Investment Trusts. So basically it is a trust, and this has been recently introduced by SEBI. So REITs and InvITs. So InvITs are Infrastructure Investment Trust. So REITs, basically they invest in real estate. So an investor who does not have enough money to directly buy real estate or any property, he can invest in this trust if he wants to benefit from the rising real estate market. So in that way, an investor can indirectly invest into the real estate sector. So it is a very positive move. So now let us read the statements. So statement 1, they are set up in the form of a trust. So statement 1 is correct. Statement 2, they can invest in commercial real estate either directly or through a special purpose vehicle. So this statement is also correct, because a REIT, real estate investment trust, it can invest in the commercial real estate, right? Commercial real estate, either directly or through a SPV. SPV, special purpose vehicle. So it is also correct. Statement 3, in India, there are two types of REITs, equity and mortgage REIT. So this statement is also correct. So as per the regulations, so there are SEBI regulations of 2014 regarding real estate investment trust. So they contain these provisions. So statement 3 is also right. Statement 4, they are required to be listed on a stock exchange. So this statement is also right. So a REIT is required to be registered on a stock exchange. And statement 5, minimum subscription amount to invest in REITs is rupees 1 lakh. Now this statement is wrong. Why? Because the minimum subscription amount is not 1 lakh, rather it is 50,000. So statement 5, it is incorrect. Now moving on to the next question, question 6. Mutual funds in India are governed by SEBI regulations 2016. Given below are some statements regarding various provisions. So you are given statements regarding provisions. So let us read the statements. Statement 1, a mutual fund is set up in the form of a trust which has sponsor, trustee, asset reconstruction company and custodian. So if you read this statement carefully, you will find that this statement is incorrect. Why? Because it is not asset reconstruction company, it is asset management company, AMC. I told you in the beginning of this video only. So there are four parties: sponsor, trustee, AMC and custodian. So it is not ARC, it is AMC. So statement 1 is incorrect. Now statement 2, while determining the prices of the units, the mutual fund shall ensure that the repurchase price is not lower than 90% of NAV and the sale price is not higher than 110% of NAV. So before discussing this statement, you should know some important terms. So first of all, what is NAV? NAV is net asset value. So it is calculated by dividing the net assets by number of units outstanding. So NAV is calculated like this. So NAV is basically the price or the value of one unit of mutual fund, right? And there are other terms also being used: repurchase price and sale price. So sale price is the price at which the investor buys the unit from the mutual fund house. So sale price and repurchase price, they are for open-ended schemes, right? And what is repurchase price? So repurchase price is the price at which the investor sells the mutual fund unit to the mutual fund house. So sale price is the price at which the investor buys the unit, and repurchase price is the price at which the investor or the unit holder sells the unit. So as per the regulations, the repurchase price, it cannot be lower than 93% of NAV, and the sale price, it cannot be higher than 107% of NAV. So statement 2 is incorrect because it is not 90 and 110, rather it is 93 and 107. And statement 3, no scheme other than equity linked saving scheme can be open for subscription for more than 15 days. So this statement is right because as per the regulations, mutual fund regulations 1996, no scheme can be open for subscription for more than 15 days. So statement 3 is correct. So the question is asking you which of the following statements are correct. So you can see only statement 3 is correct, right? So the correct option here is option E, only statement 3. Now question 7, this is the final question. Mutual funds offer a lot of benefits to the investors. Which of the following is not a benefit of investing in a mutual fund? So the options are professional management, diversification of investment, convenient administration, affordability and zero risk. So this question is to be done by you. I am not going to tell you the answer now. So you need to tell me the answer in the comment section below. Then afterwards, I will post the right answer. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then do hit the subscribe button to get more notifications and updates. Have a nice day.